In the previous videos, we've learned about amino acids, and we've learned about the charge and the speciation of those amino acids. In this video, we're going to take this idea one step further. So here's our amino acid, and I'm drawing it as we'd expect to see at a neutral pH. So a protonated amine, a deprotonated carboxylic acid. But as it turns out, there are 20 different common amino acids that we have in our bodies, and pretty much every organism has in their bodies. So the difference is what's attached to the alpha carbon. We call this the R group or the side chain. So the only thing that's different between the 20 amino acids is what's attached to the alpha carbon. So side chain chemistry is important. In this video, we're going to introduce the main categories of amino acids. We're not going to go through every single one of them, but in the image or the PDF file that I give to you next, you'll be able to see all 20 of them, and I'll let you know which of them you're responsible for and which of them I just want you to be able to recognize. Okay? So we're going to start off with the acidic amino acids. These are the ones that have acidic functional groups and tend to be deprotonated under biological conditions. And these are pretty easy to remember because they have acid in the name. So aspartic acid, this has a three-letter abbreviation of ASP. So aspartic acid, we have our standard backbone. We have one carbon hanging off of the alpha carbon, and the second one is where our carboxylic acid is. Okay, and I'm gonna go ahead and draw these as we expect to see them under biological conditions. So under neutral pHs, carboxylic acids are deprotonated. Okay, so these acidic side chains, just like the carboxylic acid in the backbone, is expected to be deprotonated. So this is aspartic acid. The other acidic amino acid is glutamic acid. Okay, and glutamic acid, or glue, looks really similar. Again, deprotonated carboxylic acid, but the difference is that we have an extra carbon hanging off of our alpha carbon. So instead of one carbon, then carboxylic acid, you have two carbons, then carboxylic acid. Okay, and again, I drew it deprotonated, so it has a negative charge. Under biological conditions, biological pHs, this is the form of glutamic acid we expect to see. So if you were to draw these protonated, you would draw the carboxylic acids, both of them being protonated. Okay, so these are the two acidic amino acids. If you're ever asked to tell me an acidic amino acid, tell me one of these two and draw them. Let's think about the two basic amino acids. Okay, here we have two of them, and they're a little bit harder to draw. Lysine, or lyse. So we have our backbone. And again, I'm going to draw this deprotonated. And then we have a long carbon chain followed by an amine group. And the way that's really easy to remember this is you have L-Y-S-I-N. So think about how to spell lysine and L-Y-S-I, and then you have the nitrogen. Okay, this is lysine. So lysine has an amino functional group, or an amine functional group. And we know that amines have pKa's up in the 9 to 10 range, so we expect lysine to be protonated at neutral pH because the pKa is really high. So we expect this to have a positive charge under neutral pH. The other basic amino acid is arginine. And this is ARG. Okay, so we start off with our backbone, carboxylic acid deprotonated, and there's no easy way to remember how to draw this. Okay, so this is the structure of arginine. What you'll notice is that under biological conditions, it also is protonated, and we're going to see that this thing has a pKa up in the range of, I believe it's 11 to 12. So in terms of charged amino acids, ones that carry, that where the side chain carries a charge, these are them. You have two acidic, aspartic acid and glutamic acid, that are deprotonated under biological conditions, so they're negative, and you have lysine and arginine that carry positive charges because they're protonated under biological conditions. Okay, let's look at a couple that contain alcohol functional groups. Okay, these are going to be serine and threonine. So serine, we have a single carbon and then an alcohol. Okay, and serine is SER. And threonine looks really similar. So threonine is THR. And again, it looks really similar. Except instead of just having the OH, you also have a second carbon hanging off of that beta carbon, or the first carbon coming off of the alpha carbon. Okay, so it looks really similar. It still has the alcohol functional group, but we also have a second CH3 group there on the beta carbon. The reason that these two amino acids are notable is because the alcohol functional group has the potential to make hydrogen bonds. So whenever you're looking for an amino acid that can make a hydrogen bond, you should perhaps think about serine or threonine because they can create these hydrogen bonds. Okay, one that's related to serine is known as cysteine. So cysteine is unique amongst the amino acids because it has a sulfur, what's called a thiol, on its side chain. So the only thing different between cysteine and serine is there's a sulfur replacing the oxygen in the alcohol functional group. So this the presence of the sulfur gives cysteine very unique properties, and we're going to learn that's really important in stabilizing the structure of many proteins. Okay, let's think about one more category of amino acids, and then you can see the rest of them by looking at a table, which will give you all of the amino acids and their properties. Okay, and these are the nonpolar ones. So amino acid side chains that do not have functional groups that make them polar. And the simplest example of this would be alanine, or ALA, ALA. So alanine is a really simple amino acid. All we have is a methyl group. Okay, so we only have a CH3 group hanging off of our alpha carbon. So alanine is a very simple amino acid to remember. When you're looking for a small side chain that's nonpolar, alanine would be a really good choice. We also have what are known as branched chain amino acids, and these are the ones that are nonpolar and have chains hanging off of the alpha carbon that are branched. One example would be valine. So valine is VAL, and valine looks pretty similar to alanine, except you have a branch. Okay, so I think this kind of looks like a person, right? So you have little legs here, and here are the arms hanging off, and imagine the hydrogen there being the head. So that's how I remembered valine when I was first learning these. You have leucine, which is another branched chain amino acid that again looks pretty similar. But this time the branch comes on the second carbon. And finally, we have isoleucine. And this is ILE. Okay, so isoleucine is almost identical to leucine, except it's an isomer. And remember, isomers are molecules that have the same number of atoms, they just have different arrangements of the functional groups. So instead of having the branch on the second carbon, this has the branch on the first carbon. So we've taken this methyl group and moved it up to the first carbon on the side chain. Okay, there are more amino acids. I'm not going to show them all to you, but in the table in Blackboard, you'll be able to see all of them with other notable information. In the next video, we're going to choose two of these amino acids and think about their acid-base properties, and then we're going to then explore some of the chemistry of the side chains of these amino acids.